Hey everyone, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's tutorial is from a picture I posted on Instagram. Many of you asked for a tutorial, so I thought I would go ahead and film that for you today. Make sure to follow me on Instagram if you want to vote on future videos. Be sure to subscribe as well so that you'll be notified whenever I post a new tutorial, and let's get started. For this hairstyle, I'm going to start by parting my hair on the right side. Then I'm going to divide out a section of hair a few inches back from my hairline on the left side and clip away the forward and back hair. I'm going to be using this section for my first Dutch braid, so I'm picking up a small piece near the part line and dividing it into three smaller sections. And I'm going to start my braid by crossing the right strand under the middle strand, then cross the left strand under the middle strand. Now I'm going to cross the right strand under the middle, pick up a new section and cross it under to the middle strand. Then I'm going to cross the left strand under the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it under to the middle strand. So once more, I'm crossing the right strand under the middle, picking up a new section and crossing it under to the middle strand. Then I'm going to cross the left strand under the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it under to the middle strand. And I'm just going to repeat those steps, crossing the side strands under the middle strand while adding new sections of hair into the braid until the braid reaches my left temple. Then once I've brought in about 4 sections and the braid reaches my left temple, I'm going to stop adding new sections into the braid and just continue braiding the section down to the ends in a regular 3-strand braid and then slide a bobby pin over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to let down the front section of hair and braid this into a second Dutch braid. So again, I'm picking up a piece near the part, dividing it into 3 smaller pieces, and I'm going to cross the side strands under the middle strand while incorporating new sections into the braid. And with this section of hair, I'm going to continue adding new sections into the braid until it reaches the top of my left ear. Now I'm going to stop bringing new pieces into the braid and just continue the braid down to the ends in a regular 3-strand braid, and then slide some more bobby pins over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to do one more Dutch braid with the hair on the right side of my head. So again, I'm picking up a new section, dividing it into 3 smaller pieces, and I'm going to cross the side strands under the middle strand while incorporating new sections into the braid. And then once the braid reaches the top of my right ear, I'm going to stop adding in new sections and just braid the hair down to the ends, sliding some more bobby pins over the bottom. Once all 3 braids are done, I'm going to go back over the braids and gently pull on the edges, just slightly to make them wider and more full. Then I'm going to take the braid from the right side, bring this around the back of my head, and pin it in place with bobby pins. Then I'm going to take the 2 braids from the left side, lay these over the right braid, and pin them against the back of my head with more bobby pins. Then I can go back and remove the bobby pins from the ends of the braids and unravel them. Now with the remaining hair left down, I'm going to create a pull-through braid. So I'm going to split this into 2 sections, a top and a bottom section. And with the top section, I'm going to divide this into 2 smaller sections, a left and a right side. Wrap these 2 sections around the bottom section of hair. And then using a clear elastic band, I'm going to tie the 2 sections together underneath. Now with the new top section of hair, I'm going to split this into 2 new sections. Wrap them around the bottom section of hair, and then tie them back together with another clear elastic band underneath. And I'm just going to repeat these steps, working my way down the section of hair until I've created 4 or 5 sections of the braid. You can create more or less, it all just depends on the length of your hair. And as I go, I'm also going to go back over the sections and pull on the outside edges so the pull-through braid looks wider and more full.
So that wraps up today's tutorial. I really hope you enjoyed today's video. I think this hairstyle is so gorgeous and will be so pretty really anywhere that you would want to wear it. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Be sure to click the thumbs up if you want to see more tutorials like this one. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you next time.